lick a counter up, cause I'm raising the bar. I shoot for the moon, but I'm too busy gazing at stars. I feel amazing and I'm not afraid.
Hey, what's going on YouTube? This is Argo, and today I'm going to be doing something a little bit different. I will be showing, it's going to be a how-to video instead of my gaming videos I usually do. And today I'll be showing you how to add songs to your video, either replace the whole video with a song, or to have the audio and song into a video all at once. And the two programs I'll be using is the Windows Live Movie Maker, which is pretty basic, but it's a little hard to try and learn. And then the next one I'll be using is Camtasia Studio 8. It's harder to learn, but it's all more worth it. It's a little bit high tech, so you can do a little bit more stuff with it. So let's get started. So first you need your iTunes Store. And you want to find the song that you would like, and it has to be in the MP3 version to be able to pull it up onto these programs. So what you want to do, and I already did this, as you can see it's right there, my MP3 version. What you want to do is right click on the video, then you'll go down to create MP3 version. Then you'll click that, then you should hear a little ding sound when it's done. Then what you want to do, you want to exit out of that. Go to Start, go to Music, and you'll go into iTunes, iTunes Media, Music, then you'll find the artist that you went under, and in this case mine is Flowrider, and it's Whistle, and you'll want to check the item types, and this one's the MPEG-4 audio, which is a YouTube audio, so that won't work. And right here is MP3 format sound, so that one should work. So you want to take the MP3, pull it out onto your desktop screen, exit out of that, then pull up the Windows Live Movie Maker. Then you'll want to add the video that you want to use. In this case, I'll just be adding a random one that I got here. And then it'll take a second to load. I got it, so now here we have the video, and I'll play it a little bit for you. It was a little laggy there, my bad. But anyways, you got the sound there, and you can go over to edit, and you can edit the volume rate. Make sure you have the video clip clicked first, and then go to the edit, then go to video volume, and you can decrease it to where it doesn't play any sound, or increase it all the way. Then when you want to add the music, just press add music, go to your desktop, then you want to find it. Might take me a little bit, I got a lot of stuff. There we go. Then you press open, and it should put the song all the way onto there. Which is, in this case, this clip is longer than the song. So we'll just cut it right here. We'll split, and then cut, then delete. Okay, there we go. Now the clip is the same size. And then I'll give you a little preview. Can you blow my whistle? Then again, sorry for the lag, I don't know why it's doing that. But anyways, see, then you got the song. So you want to click the song, then go to the music tools and the music volume. And then again, you can do the same thing, increase it, decrease it. Then you have it fade in and fade out when it's done. And then that's pretty much all you do if you want to have just the music playing. Just click on the video, video volume, make sure to go to the video tools, video volume, press it all the way down, and it should just be playing And that was how to do just a song. If you want to have the song louder than the video, all you do is just put the video volume up a little bit and the song volume however you want it, then that should work just fine. And then that's going to be it for the Windows Live Movie Maker. Okay, we are here in Camtasia Studio 8. I'll already put the files in, but I'll show you how to do that. Go into Import Media and just find where your video clip file is at. Which in this case, it's down in one of these files. Gotta find it first. There we go. Then I just click it and press open and it's already in for me. And then you just want to find your... go to your desktop and get your music file. Then you just enter that into... Then what you want to do is drag the video into track 1. Then there wouldn't be a track here. So let me move that real fast. It'll just look like that. Make sure to drag the video over to... now it's at the start there. Then just do the same thing with this, but add it up here. Now make it into a new track and drag. And then you want to go over to audio. And depending on how you want it, like say you want no audio from the video and you just want the song, just drag that down all the way. Then you just got the song right there, which I'm not going to play because it's going to be too loud. So then I'll also undo this here. But if you want the same, well, the song, you want the audio and the song together, but you want the sound a little bit down, like more, you want more song than audio, then just adjust it to how you like it. And also, if the song, if you like, if it looks like this, to where it doesn't start till about three seconds, then you can, all you have to do is go right there, press this, and you right click, and then, wow, I just forgot how to do this myself. Oh, there we go. Then you press the split, and it splits it, that way you can start it off right at the beginning instead of waiting for a little bit, or you can just start it wherever you want. But then, also you can do what I like to do, is the, like, fade in types, but I add audio points, so add audio point right there, drag that down, and then it'll fade in. And then you can just have it at what level you want to fade it into at, and that's pretty much how you do this, how I do my songs. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and like me on Facebook. Then I forgot to tell you guys, and I'm editing the current video right now that I'm going to put up, but I forgot to tell you, when you're all done with it and you're happy with it, and you want to export it, you go over here up to File, go to Produce and Share, or you can just press Produce and Share right there. You click that, you go down and press Custom Production Settings, and sometimes it's already selected for you. Press Next. Make sure it's Windows Media Video and nothing else. Press Next. Next. And make sure it's on 1280 by 720. And if you had it in this on 1280 by 720, then it should already be there for you and you don't have to do anything. Then you just press Next. Then you don't have to do anything with this. Next. Then you can just name it right here. And just name whatever you want to name it right here. This is the folder it goes to. Then you don't have to do anything else. Then you press Finish. And then it will take probably like 5-10 minutes depending on how long your video is. But it can take a long time for it to finish uploading. But it's worth it. And that's all.
What you thinking?
The crew's ready downstairs. Say the word and we crash the party.
Let's do it.
All right, you're clear. I really gotta stop doing this shit.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Screams from the haters, got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. The system broken, the school's closed, the prison's open. We ain't got nothing.